Hello everyone, this is our third and last session of lesson number 4, diseases. Okay, so in this session we are going to revise all the things, all the points that we have completed in our previous session, and one small point, that is epidemics. Okay, so first we will revise the things and then we will learn that new points. Okay, so at the start of our lesson we have learned some definitions, okay, of germs, diseases, symptoms, diagnosis and prevention. Okay, so germs means what? The small tiny living things. Okay, because of that there are diseases, so that are known as germs. Okay, very tiny things. Okay, then we have learned about diseases. So because of the germs there is an unhealthy condition or unhealthy thing that is happening in our body, in our mind. So that condition is known as disease. Okay, so there are many diseases we have learned. Then we have learned about symptoms. So symptoms means what? Your runny nose, headache, body pain, rashes, redness, itching. So all the external signs, okay, what all the external signs shown by our body are known as symptoms. Now if there are symptoms, means there is a disease. So who is going to diagnose that? The doctor. So that method of identifying a particular disease, okay, so that technique or that method is known as diagnosis. Understood? And prevention. Okay, after diseases, after getting the germs enter in our body, we are doing some things or we are applying techniques, so that are known as prevention. Okay, so prevention and treatment, there is a difference. Prevention we are doing before disease and treatment we are doing after diseases. Okay, so always prevention is better than cure. Okay, so that much definitions we have learned. Then we have learned two types of diseases, that diseases spread and diseases do not spread. Okay, so in diseases that spread, four ways are there. Now spreading of diseases means what? From one person to another person there is a traveling of that disease. So there are four ways of spreading. First one, airborne diseases, waterborne diseases, diseases by touching and diseases by insect. So like that four ways we have learned. So there are airborne diseases means what? The diseases which spread by air, like common cold, cough. Understood? Then waterborne diseases, diseases that spread through water. Only you have to change the word. So diseases that spread through water are known as waterborne diseases. Diseases that spread through touch, okay, and diseases that spread through insects like malaria, dengue. Okay, so like that we have completed diseases that spread. Many examples we have learned, like typhoid, malaria, chikungunya. Okay, then we have learned the symptoms of that diseases, and that you have to learn at least 2 to 3 symptoms of each and every disease. Then we have learned diseases that do not spread, means there is no air medium, water medium, touching or insects. So that happens, okay, diseases that do not spread means what? Diseases that happens because of the lack of nutrients in your diet. So that we have learned in prevention. Okay, diseases that spread, that prevention also we have learned. Diseases that do not spread, there are also prevention, that you have to eat balanced diet, then exercise, eat plenty amount of water. So many preventions are given. Then vaccination, avoid the collection of stagnant water. So like that we have completed our prevention. So like this we have completed our revision. But understood? Any doubt in any concept? If any doubt, okay, you can ask me directly. Now the new point is that is epidemics. Now epidemics means what? So that is a serious condition in which, because of a particular disease, there is a huge loss of human life. Means this epidemics directly affect human life. Okay, not only 1 or 10 or 100 people are dying. So in epidemic, thousands of people, or sometimes the number is in lakhs, in crore. Life, you can say that. Now which epidemics is going on? Which epidemics? The severe condition in which many people are dying. Which condition is going on? Because of that, we are not going outside. Because of that, we are wearing masks, drinking the boiled water. Yes, epidemic is of corona. Okay, so understood what is an epidemic? A serious condition in which, because of diseases or any disease, there is a huge loss of human life. Understood? So that epidemic note is given in your page book test number 19. The corona is a live example that we are now experiencing. Okay, that epidemics we are going through that. So many epidemics are there, like smallpox, plague, yellow fever, malaria, SARS, Ebola, and Zika virus epidemic. So many examples happen with us. Okay, we were going through that epidemics. Means already many people have lost their life because of that epidemics. So understood? Any doubt about epidemics? A small point is here. And then one last point, that is a note to parent. Okay, so see that health and hygiene are important to keep us safe from diseases. So help your child follow these 6 golden rules to prevent diseases. It is not compulsory that parents should tell their child. Okay, the students are also responsible for that, to take care of their own body. Understood? So what you have to follow? First one, keeping their hands clean. Okay, before and after eating, you have to wash your hands. Then after going to toilet, again you have to wash your hands and legs. Means you have to clean your body. Next one, being active every day. Means exercise or playing outdoor games. Active means what? You have to do something for your body. Like exercise, yoga, or you can play the outdoor games. Understood? The second one, getting plenty of sleep. At least we have to take 6 to 7 hours of sleeping. Understood? Then not putting their fingers in their mouth, ears or nose. Okay, we are touching everywhere. If without washing our hands, we are putting our fingers in mouth, in nose. Okay, so there is a possibility for the entry of germs. So avoid that. Next one, drinking lots of water. As I have said that, balanced diet where the all nutrients are present. But not only nutrient, water is also important to our body. So for that, drink plenty amount of water, and if possible, please drink boiled water, because boiling keeps the germs that present in water. Understood? And the last one, eating healthy food. Instead of junk food, instead of fast food, we have to eat healthy food. Green leafy vegetables, many fruits are there, many vegetables are there, that we have to eat. Understood about this lesson? Okay, so here we have completed our lesson. Now what is your homework? You have to start writing off your workbook, that is your lesson number 4, diseases. Okay, I will provide you the answer key, but still you have to write that. Read the lesson properly, read the symptoms, read all definitions, then the differences between diseases that spread, diseases that do not spread. Then the examples are there. All the things you have to recite. Okay? Till stay home, stay safe, and thank you.